1968 began badly for the Dark Railway. A huge storm blew over the line a few days into the new year, causing severe damage all over the railway. The worst affected area, however, was Axley. Mr. Dark was devastated to find that the station canopy at Axley Station had blown down, smashing up half the station and causing considerable damage to the track. He had no choice but to close the line for a few days whilst the mess was cleared away. However, thanks to an insurance payoff, Mr. Dark decided that now was the time to finally double the southern section of the line between Woolchurch and Gallen Junction, as well as a complete rebuild of Axley Station so that it had two fully usable platforms once again. The engines were enthusiastic about this. Finally! How long have I been banging on about doubling the line? About 4,000 years. Exactly! And this means we won't have to hang around at Woolchurch waiting for the single line token. But there's only one thing that I don't understand. What? We're not going to be able to run trains down there for a while, are we? We can. Didn't you listen to Mr. Dark earlier? Do I ever? He said that we can still use the line once the work's carried out. Oh. Damn! I was looking forward to a long west. Ah, well. I wonder what Mr. Dark's going to do about banking engines while I'm gone. What? Going somewhere? You really don't listen to Mr. Dark, do you? I'm off to the Bluebell Railway in a few days. Why? I'm being loaned to them for the summer. Then they're going to take me for my overhaul during the winter, in exchange for my services. But the Bluebell's only, what, 3 miles long at the moment? Exactly. I get a nice relaxing summer, whilst you're stuck here pulling trains over the hills, probably without help. Damn it. The doubling of the railway began at the end of January, by which time Brian had already buggered off to the Bluebell Railway. Trains of steel, wooden sleepers and ballast were brought to Gallen Junction, where the work was to begin. Allan was put in charge of moving the various wagons around for ease of the workers. To avoid disruption, the first task for the track layers was to create a small section of double track just past the signal box at the junction. This would allow Allan to shunt the wagons onto this section of track whilst the workmen worked their way north. Once the first section was built, a new set of points was constructed, allowing access to it. But Allan was confused when he rolled up there one day to look at the new track.
Well, this will certainly improve capacity as well, but what are those points there for? They don't lead anywhere.
Those are catch points, Allan.
What points?
Catch.
And what are they for?
Well, it's a safety precaution. Those points lead to nowhere when the incoming signal is at danger.
And what good is that?
It's to prevent trains overriding the signal and fouling the single track section. Also good to stop runaways, in fact.
Seems pretty silly to me. I mean, I appreciate safety as much as the next engine, but we haven't had any major accidents for years.
The driver smiled.
You never know, Allan. There's always one time that something could go wrong, and you can't be too safe with railways, especially at a busy junction like here.
Allan grunted, then continued back down the line to collect some more trucks for the workmen. The following week, Allan found himself once again sitting on the new section of track, holding the trucks in position, whilst the men worked with them. He would stand here for long periods of time during the day, waiting until the workmen had finished with the wagons. He then had to wait until there was a clear path down to the yard so he could take the empty trucks away and bring up more loaded ones. Often, he would see other engines passing by. Some, like Lino, asked him how the track laying was going. Others, like 257 Squadron, chuckled as Allan stood there waiting.
Having a good old rest, Allan?
Never mind, eh? Leave all the work to our big, strong engines. Haven't you got a chain to break or something, or an oil bath to set alight?
But 257 didn't hear him as he roared away. Later on, Allan was stood with a long train of full ballast wagons, ready for spreading. Dave was waiting at the station, having been given the chance to pull a passenger train for a bit. Allan was waiting patiently for the workers to get on with their work, but mostly on a tea break, reading magazines or eating sandwiches. Suddenly, from round the corner, Allan's driver appeared.
I'll be back in 10 minutes, Allan. Sit tight, won't you?
Like I have a choice. Where are you going?
Off to the little boy's room.
Joy. His driver walked away towards the workmen, no doubt hoping he could use their portable toilets. Allan had just started to wonder if he had time for a quick nap when he felt his wheels begin to move on their own accord. Oh, crumbs! What's happening? The trucks were just as surprised as him. They screeched as they, along with Allan, gathered momentum as they rolled down the hill back towards the junction. Allan tried to stop himself, but it was impossible. To make matters even worse, Allan heard a whistle and the sound of pistons. Dave had left the station with his passenger train. Crap, 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 I'm gonna smash into him! Dave, who had just spotted Allan, clearly thought the same and screeched at his crew. Stop! Stop! We're going to crash! Stop! But they were both wrong. Allan closed his eyes as he rolled towards the points, but instead of veering right onto the line, he veered left, onto the catch points. With a crunch and a jolt, Allan opened his eyes and found himself derailed in a mound of earth, slightly hurt, but safe. The wagons had come off too, but they were okay as well, and were actually giggling about their situation. Allan did not. He felt ridiculous. Dave came to a halt alongside of his train. Jesus, Allan, you nearly gave me boiler failure. Sorry, I don't know what happened. Well, at least we know the catch points work. Yeah, there is that at least. Well, I'd best be on my way if you're all right. I'll get someone to come along and sort you out in a minute. Yeah, I'm fine, Dave. You get your passenger sorted out. Dave puffed away as Allan's driver came charging up to him.
Oh, crikey. What happened?
You tell me. His driver jumped into the cab and came back looking shocked a few minutes later.
Oops.
Oh, what an adequate response. What the hell did you do wrong this time?
I didn't do nothing. Your brakes came off. That's why you rolled.
And that's my fault. How?
Well, it ain't my fault.
You shouldn't have gone to the loo.
I was desperate.
Both Allan and his driver continued to argue for a while, until Camber arrived with a recovery crew and a crane. From out of the train came Mr. Dark, who started walking towards Allan and his driver. You're right, Allan.
Fine, thanks.
Well, well, Allan, what do we have here?
An accident, sir.
Oh, indeed. It looks like your air brakes were not secured properly. And where were you when all this happened, driver?
Oh, I...
He went for a slash, sir. I think we need some private word, driver, about your actions. Allan, I'll get you out as soon as I can. I'm glad I sanctioned the construction of these catch points now. There could have been an even nastier accident if they hadn't been there.
Yes, sir.
So, Allan and the trucks were soon lifted back onto the line. Allan was checked all over at the junction and found to be in good working order with some light repairs to be made. Allan's driver, of course, was sacked the next day for negligence and for leaving his workstation. So Allan got a new, more competent driver from that point onwards. He gets on better with his new driver anyway. As for the catch points, Allan has found a new respect for them and doesn't think they're silly anymore.